Next, I will ask Nikhil Hirdaramani, Director of Sustainability for the Hirdaramani Group, NEO Global Executive Education Committee Chair.
Thank you, everybody. Good afternoon. First, I have to make a confession. I am not an SME. I'm involved in a family business. We employ over 60,000 people in the fashion industry. But why I'm actually here is because I believe, as an industry, as a sort of large industry, it's our responsibility actually to support SMEs and sustainability, because I think sustainability in the future is not a comparative advantage. It's something that everyone has to do. And, you know, we're here representing EO, and I think we're here because we're passionate about what we want to do. We're passionate, we want to help. And I think passion is the first fundamental thing you need to have in order to actually achieve sustainability. So my journey in sustainability, I realized when I first joined the business that as a manufacturer, there wasn't really an element of representation in sustainability. So over recent years, I have got involved in sustainability within my own business, but also on a more mass scale, globally involved in organizations. I'm in the fashion industry. If you look at the SDGs, the fashion industry is probably one of the largest in relation to the SDGs in terms of impact. So we are doing quite a lot. What I want to share with you is what we're actually doing in my organization, but also some of the challenges and maybe some of the things that we need to do to improve. So our sustainability journey, we're a family business. Most businesses today actually statistically are family businesses, and we all run on family values. So family values have an impact. So we've, in terms of sustainability, it's probably been in our DNA. Our embedded values passed on through generations have long placed sustainability as part of our business approach. It was really in 2006 as a family, after probably watching Al Gore's Inconvenient Truth, that we decided to elevate sustainability as a core focus area in our strategy and market it. We opened the first ever carbon neutral factory, garment factory, in Sri Lanka, Asia's first carbon neutral factory in Asia, in 2008. And we focused on four pillars: water, waste, energy, and people. Today, our strategy has evolved. I would say at that particular time, it was very much based on the environment, but the social impact has now become a huge part of our sustainability strategy. And it's linked very much to sustainability development goals. The guides both our environmental and social sustainable goals, enable us to pursue a people, planet, profit approach and do our part for the prosperity of future generations. We acknowledge, however, I want to sort of outline some of the goals that we are achieving. And I first of all, I want to talk about our values. And this is where there needs to be an evolution. We've also had to change. And we're entrepreneurs. I mean, I think my fellow EO colleague just mentioned it. You know, we just get on with it. You know, we just have to change, you know. And we've had to evolve our values to deal with the fourth industrial revolution. So our values, I mean, we have love what you do. You know, you've got to be passionate. If you're not passionate, as I mentioned, you're not going to achieve this. Trust and respect. Make an impact, which is a value for EO, actually. We all want to make an impact. We all want to make a difference. Innovation and creativity. And, you know, we talk about where sort of people, you know, in terms of jobs. Now, my personal view on where jobs are going to go, I'm in the apparel industry. Can automation change the apparel industry? There'll be elements of automation, yes. But there'll also be creation of new jobs within industry. I mean, the fact that Amazon now is a player in our field shows you that technology is going to play an important part, and the sort of construction and of garments may be more complex in the future. And one team. You know, I come from Sri Lanka, was a developing country, moving forward now. But it was also a former colony. But now the fact that we're all looking at it as one team, we all work together, there's no hierarchical structure in our organization, and that's what you have to do to be able to work with the millennials and Generation X. So if we look at the sustainable development goals that we're actually working on, I've heard a few people mention today about well-being. So we have a very extensive well-being program in our organization, and I think this is where our role as an organization to develop the future, to develop the people of the future to be able to take on jobs. So we have sort of seven achievements within our well-being program: a healthy workforce, a wealthy workforce, a happy, productive, loyal, self-esteemed and green. And it's a very extensive program across all our employees that we're developing this. And again, it's a way that we are developing the future. Clean energy, we've put solar panels on all our roofs. Decent work and economic growth. As I mentioned, our industry is evolving. Technology is becoming an important part, but it creates more jobs. And we're looking at how we can sort of support that in employing relevant people for that. Responsible consumption and production. Now, one of the challenges that I see in our industry is waste. We've got a huge issue with waste. And I think that we are looking at how we can, you know, people talk about the circular economy in our industry, collaboration. And I feel that we all need to get together. I think the days of when there was buyers and there were two separate entities of buyers and sort of manufacturers has changed. We're now all working together. And I think really the theme, if there's something you take back from what I say, the future is where we have to collaborate. We are working with our major customers now on a number of projects that address the UN Sustainable Development Goals. We're working with customers like Patagonia to rebuild a rainforest in Sri Lanka that was seriously affected by floods. We're working with some new customers in the UK to give scholarships to students in Sri Lanka. So I think one of the other things that we're also looking at, collaboration from the point of view of changing the industry. One of the biggest challenges in the apparel industry has been the number of audits that we have to go through. Factories have to go through a number of audits, some of them quite trivial. The fact that we've now got the whole industry working together to try and bring this down is going to create so much more time, save money, and give us the opportunity to add resources to achieve the Sustainable Development Goals. So for me, it's about working together, cutting out all the sort of hierarchy, and I believe the future. I believe the future is quite. I'm optimistic about the future, but work together. That's what's needed. Thank you.